Hey guys, Wake Rider here, playing a little bit of Lumphini Garden and using the all-new unlockable sniper rifle, bolt action, CS5. And I've had a lot of fun with this gun. To be honest with you, when it first came out, I kind of hated it, and I was just like, I don't know if I'm really ever going to be able to get used to this naturally suppressed bolt action rifle. You can't take the suppressor off, but it comes automatically with the suppressor on. And I really love using these little tiny Raven SUAVs. And not only can you spot out and mark and everything else with vehicles and stuff like that for your guys on the ground that go blow up, but you also can have just an absolute blast trolling people. So what I like to do is like it to fly around, let the battery get a little low, and then just go ahead and try to take somebody out. Because you know they're looking at their kill feed and going like, SUAV? How the hell did that just happen? But I had a really good round this time with the CES5. And, you know, as much as I did not think I was going to like this gun, I actually just kind of forced myself to use it. And continuously started to evolve slowly but surely with using this gun. Now, one of the big things that I did notice, and like we have been doing in the previous videos, is I will compare this to the CSLR-4 over and over again, just because the CSLR-4 is the most vanilla sniper rifle, and it's also a pretty decent rifle, and it's very well-rounded. So we'll be kind of comparing to that pretty much non-stop. But as far as the comparison goes, of course, like I said, this weapon is suppressed. Now, one of the differences with the CS5 is it does use a 308 or a 7.62 round. And a lot of rifles do that. It's actually a very popular hunting caliber weapon, is the 308 or the 7.62, depending if you're using metrics or not. But a lot of the other sniper rifles, especially bolt action, with inside of Battlefield 4, use the 338 round, which is a little larger round and packs a little more punch. So it's just interesting to see the damage models being a little bit different with the CS5 versus some of the 338 round items, or even the some of the blackout round items. So, but anyways, as far as some of the advantages of CS5 goes to the CSLR4, is it does fire the rounds a lot faster, and that's one of the things when I'm playing aggressive recon that I really like on my side, because you know, even with the straight bolt pull and all that included, it's really nice to be able to fire, you know, take that split second, get another round in the chamber, and fire again just in case you miss. I mean, sniping is by far, especially when you start playing aggressively, sniping is not a perfect science. You do the best you can when you can, and that's why you really see so many montages with sniper rifles, is because those moments where you get those those feeds, or you get those distant shots, or you get those sequences, are really so far and few between, and have to kind of almost magically line up for you. It's a combination of being in the right position at the right time, and it's a combination of skill, and it's really kind of, you know, as much as I don't really believe in quote unquote luck, you have to get a little bit lucky, because these guys, you have to be better than them, and then also they just kind of have to fall into line with you with how you are playing and what you want to do, and then they kind of just follow like ducks in a row, I guess. But so definitely the slightly higher rate of fire does help a lot, especially when you're playing aggressive. And that's one thing I did notice with the suppressor on, is being that if you do miss that first round, a lot of people are kind of like, where the hell did that just come from? Because you're not showing up on the mini-map. But on the adverse side of that, I did notice a few times when I was close, because the damage model on this particular rifle only goes out 100% to about 12 meters. So if you are beyond 12 meters, say you're 15 meters, say you're 20 meters, which is pretty damn close. If you hit them square in the chest, you know, and you kind of like slap shot them, or you kind of like quick scope them, or whatever you want to call it, they will still survive. And you are pretty screwed unless you were able to get another round off. So that's kind of an advantage, but also a disadvantage all at the same time. Now, one of the other things, it does have a lot of less spread whether it's hip fire, crouching, or moving, or laying down without the bipod deployed. They have a lot of advantages over the CSLR-4, the CS-5 does. So that's definitely something, as far as when you're looking to go an aggressive recon, that has a huge advantage on your behalf. And I think that's why you see a lot of guys, especially shooting at distance, that actually use a CSLR-4. But like I said, aggressively, I think really the CS-5 is going to be your best bet. Now, watch this really carefully, this little sequence right here. I found this absolutely hilarious. I didn't notice it until I played it back. But I get killed here, and this guy, you know, he's got me with the SW-40, because we all know, like, all of a sudden, Battlefield 4 loves their freaking one-shot pistols. So, he goes and hides in that little bush. So I spawn right in on this objective, ready to go get some of my vengeance, and he gets crushed by the commander dropping an ammo crate. I just found that personally absolutely hilarious, and like I said, I didn't really notice it until I actually started reviewing the footage, so I just found that funny. Hopefully you guys see, that's like a Battlefield Friends moment right there, but it actually happened in real life, so. And you can hear him actually scream on the video, like, ah, it's like ammo crates hitting him too, which is great. So some of the advantages of the CSLR-4 that definitely are way over top of, not even close to the CS-5, is one thing I noticed right away, and I've already kind of touched on it, is the has a much longer maximum distance. So you're talking 500 more meters. The CSLR-4 is going to be able to really do some damage at more than the CS-5. And so the CSLR-4 will go about 2,500 meters, and the CS-5 is only going to be about 2,000 meters. So it's a huge difference, about another quarter longer than the CS-5. And another huge thing as well that you notice pretty much right away, and it definitely has to be a portion of it being that it is suppressed, but even when I took the suppressor off of the CS-5, it still seemed to have a lot of bullet drop, and that is all due to the higher muscle velocity that the CSLR-4 has over top of the CS-5. Huge difference here, 67% faster, greater with 500 meters per second versus 300 meters per second of the CSLR-4 advantage over top of the CS-5. And that's one thing that really took me a while to get used to, because the bullet, you can actually see it leave the muzzle and travel, where at some of my other ones, like the FYJS or the Gall Magnum, they just go and they hit the target and that's it. So as far as in general, it's fun to use, and it does a decent job suppressed, but it's a little frustrating all at the same time. So, I'm not a huge fan of it. I think there's a lot of better rifles out there to use in it, especially aggressively. But, you know, nevertheless, it was a lot of fun to use. So, let me know what you guys think down in the comments. Until then, I'll see you next time.